Hello guys, welcome back with me, Ciao 2025. Today, we're going to unleash the true potential of your imaginations with Animatediff, an extension that lets you transform your Stable Diffusion masterpieces into breathtaking animations. Get ready to add a whole new dimension to your AR journey. Imagine your AI art bursting with life, characters dancing, landscapes morphing, and stories unfolding in mesmerizing loops. This is the magic of Animatediff for Stable Diffusion in Automatic1111. Today, we'll unleash this animation power, step by step. Before we dive in, let's check compatibility. Animatediff currently requires Windows or Linux.
Also, VRAM usage depends on your image size and context batch size.
You can try to reduce image size or context batch size to reduce ROM usage. Also use XFormer to reduce VRAM significantly. Now, let's install the Automatic1111 Animatediff extension.
From Automatic1111 window, go to Extension tab. Click Available, click Load From, and the search for Animatediff.
After you found it, click Install.
After it's installed, go to Installed tab and then click Apply and Restart UI.
When Automatic1111 is showing up, check if you have a new menu below that is Animatediff.
Check the menu. You will see the motion module is empty. We need to download the model first.
This model is located at huggingface.co/goiw/animatediff/tree/main.
I also put the link on the description. You need to download the motion model. I suggest you use the latest one that is MMSDV15V2.CKPT.
There are also a bunch of Laura here, but for this video, we will ignore it for now.
Save the file in uweb.ui/extensions/sdweb.ui/animatediff/model.
While we wait, I will explain the function of the setting of the Animatediff. Save format is what you want the format of your output. You need to choose at least one, but you could choose more. Check TXT if you want info text, which will live in the same directory as the output GIF.
Number of frames, choose how many frames you want. If you enter 0, the number of frames will be your context batch size described below.
If you enter something smaller than your context batch size other than 0, you will get the first number of frames as your output GIF from your whole generation. All following frames will not appear in your generated GIF, but will be saved as PNG as usual. Do not set number of frames to be something smaller than context batch size other than 0.
FPS is frames per second, which is how many frames images are shown every second. If 16 frames are generated at 8 frames per second, your GIF's duration is 2 seconds.
Display loop number.
This decide how many times the GIF is looped. A value of 0 means the GIF never stops playing.
Context batch size is how many frames will be passed into the motion module at once.
The S-Done.5 motion modules are trained with 16 frames, so it'll give the best results when the number of frames is set to 16.
Closed loop. Decide to make the last frame the same as the first frame.
Option means absolutely no closed loop. Minus P means that the extension will try to reduce the number of closed loop context.
R plus P means that the extension will try to reduce the number of closed loop context.
A means that the extension will aggressively try to make the last frame the same as the first frame. The prompt travel will be interpolated to be a closed loop.
Stride mean max motion stride as a power of 2.
Overlap is number of frames to overlap in context.
Frame interpolation.
Interpolate between frames.
Video source and video path will be talking later video. You need control net to do this.
Move a motion video to QPU, just don't use this. It gonna make the process really slow.
How to use Animatediff. For testing, I suggest you use 2Nubita6 model for cartoon model or Realistic Division 2 for realistic picture. Let's make an example using 2Nubita6 model. What you need to do first is to make sure you check the Enable Animatediff. Let's leave everything at default for now and make a prompt. For negative prompt, let's use worst quality, low quality, letterboxed. For positive prompt, let's try flying bird, blue sky. For sample method, I use DPM plus a caret. The other is at default value, click generate. It's going to take a while. Let's wait. Okay, we'll make a grid, something like a sprite in 2 games. Now, you will see the picture is moving. It generates for 1:24 for this GIF file. But as you can see, the loop is not natural because the bird in the last frame suddenly jumped to the front. If you want it to be a closed loop, just select the loop to A and then we use the same seed. Now, let's click generate. Now, as you can see, the bird moving in closed loop. Of course, with very low frame, this generates a very strange animation. If you don't want close loop, simply click now. If you want longer animation, you could manually put number of frames manually. You should put in above context, and it should be able to be divided by your FPs. So I put 48 for FPs 8. It means it is gonna be a 6-second animation. Of course, longer animation mean longer processing time. Okay, that's the result. It is pretty long, but nothing special. So let's make another example. This is another example. If we draw characters, the water is moving great. For now, we can't control the flow of the animation. But we can actually use prompt traveling to somehow influence the animation. You could put a frame number, then column. After that, put your first prompt there. Then you press enter and add a new frame number with column and with prompt. You could repeat this as many times as you want, as long as the frames exist. Here in this example, I put a girl walking for the first 0:15 frame and make her running for the 16:31 frame and make her flying in the rest of the frame. The result is not that good, but that just example. Also, you could use erase fix for the image if you want. I'm not going to use it for now since it takes a long time just to process the regular image. This example, I use realism 50 model. It looking great. Okay, guys, this is another example. For now, I end this video. There are many tricks that we could use with Animatediff, but we could talk about it on the next video. Thanks for watching, and have a nice day.